Today on Follow That Somm, we're popping champagne at Terroir TriBeCa. Sommelier Sabra Lewis believes that champagne is a perfect pairing wine, especially for Terroir's delicious pork belly and pineapple sliders. Hi everyone, we're here with Sabra Lewis, sommelier at Terroir TriBeCa, to taste champagne.
Yay!
Can you tell me in one sentence, why is Terroir dear to you?
I love this place because it's not pretentious, but everything is done at a very high level. And we have a great toolbox, which means we have a cool menu of wines and beer, cocktails, anything with alcohol to play with. People are so receptive to it.
Can you give us an overview of Champagne?
Champagne is a place in France, a very large wine region devoted to bubbles, devoted to sparkling wine production. And it's also a process too. So a wine of place and a wine of process.
Any sparkling wine from any location other than Champagne is not allowed to be called Champagne.
Correct.
Is that correct?
Yes.
Can you tell us about the Champagne method?
A method traditionelle is the technical term for producing bubbles in the bottle, and it's basically a second fermentation in the bottle. And when they bottle it, they add a little bit of yeast and a little bit more sugar, and then they cap it, and then that bottle starts to re-ferment again. So that produces a little bit more alcohol and a little bit of gas, and that's captured the bubbles.
If we're talking champagne, what are the typical grapes in champagne?
So champagne, we think of three major grapes, but there are actually seven that are allowed. But we're talking about Chardonnay, Pinot Noir, and Pinot Meunier. There's a lot of ways to compare champagne. You can compare different terroirs, you can compare different grape varieties, but I wanted to do the idea of like a mature wine and a single vineyard wine. So these are the exact opposite styles, but both great growers. The first wine is Champagne Doyard, a grower producer. It's a single vintage Champagne 2010, and it's their Clos de Abbey.
This is a single vintage and single vineyard.
Yeah.
So single year produced and single plot of land.
Yes, correct. Clos is a walled-in vineyard.
Thank you.
Use a glass that allows some generosity because
some breath, some openness.
Yeah. You know, don't worry so much about the bubbles. The bubbles will always be there, and they're always going to be delicious, and that's obvious. So beyond the bubbles, really think of it like a wine.
Okay. So what are you smelling?
White peach, lemon, sea spray, saline. You know, light buttery toast, maybe
toast.
Just a little bit. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you could almost just stop here and just.
You really could.
But we shouldn't. We should drink it.
The closest thing I can say, I mean, kind of the bready quality for me.
Yeah.
The saline, as you said, like the savory sort of the seaside is huge for me.
Huge. We have the lemon, we have maybe the white peach, we have the yellow apple, and but also it's that amazing sea spray and the salt and the chalk and the chalky texture. When you're in champagne, the chalk is everywhere. You can see it. It's visible. You can take little pieces and write with it. So it's pretty literal. The second wine is Champagne Curée. It's Memoir is the cuvée name. And this is a perpetual cuvée. And so they blended it from 82 to 2012, and they bottled it in 2014.
30 years of work. And it only retails for something like, what, 60 bucks?
It's around 60 bucks, retail. The perpetual cuvée is meant to express a certain terroir. And when you blend vintage after vintage after vintage, what ends up happening is the vintage kind of like is less important, and the terroir rises to the top and is the most expressive part of the champagne. Because this wine has got some age to it, you know, at least in the winemaking process, really the fruit is on the back end. There's no fruit in this. It's all savory. And wow, it does have this like soy.
So what I'm getting in this, a lot of savory first, where before it was a little brighter, it felt a little, I don't know, younger, a little more apple-y.
You're getting these, you know, already sort of like oxidative notes, like, you know, red apple skin and, you know, maybe nuts or brioche.
Mm.
Yeah. Like clean mushroom, things like that.
So this is a little more toasty, bready. That's a little bit more citrus chalky.
Yeah.
Let's eat.
Awesome.
So these are our pork belly sliders with pickled pineapple, fried herbs, and with some barbecue sauce.
Thank you so much.
Yum.
Cannot wait. This is insane.
Yeah.
What should I anticipate with this pairing?
Deliciousness. I have bubbles to cut through any of the fat of the pork. The natural sort of brioche character of champagne is great with bread. And then because this one's aged, we're talking an older wine, we have a bit more of that hoisin character already in the wine, which is in the food also. So
with this hoisin sauce,
this is a very like with like pairing.
It's still so warm. Oh my goodness. Oh my god. Okay, that is insane. The brioche is sweet and bready and yeasty and gorgeous.
Yeah.
Yeah, the pineapple is pretty strong in that, which I love.
Yeah.
Let's see how it goes with this. But the bread is just like heightened to a new level.
Yeah, sure.
And then like I am getting more of that savory. I don't know what that savory, I still don't know what it is. It's like 5 times bigger after this.
Yeah, yeah. Like what finishes is that sauce, you know? And that's like the acid in the sauce with the acid in the wine is happy, very happy.
Happy. Sabra.
Yes.
You're amazing. you have been followed. Thank you for everything.
Thank you. Thanks for drinking with me.
When can I come back?
A big thanks to Sabra Lewis and Terroir TriBeCa for letting us follow that Somm. For more articles and videos, head to wineforfood.com.